Hello students, welcome to your digital classroom. In today's session, we will be discussing about the lesson, The Fundamental Unit of Life. And the topics that we will be dealing with are mitochondria, plastids and lysosomes. Now let us move on to our first topic, that is mitochondria. Now mitochondria is a cell organelle which was discovered by Kolliker and Benda. Now moving on to its structure, mitochondria is a double membrane bound structure. It has got one outer membrane, one inner membrane. Now the inner membrane of mitochondria is deeply folded to form curves or inner corners which are called cristae. Now cristae is the plural form of it. Again, the inner membrane of the mitochondria has got a proteinaceous matrix inside it which is called the mitochondrial matrix. The inner membrane or the mitochondrial matrix has also got DNA and ribosomes in it. Now these ribosomes are again going to help in protein synthesis like you know. So let us now discuss about what is the function of these cristae or why the inner membrane of mitochondria is deeply folded. So inner membrane of mitochondria is deeply folded to provide a large surface area for the production of ATP. Now what is ATP? ATP is basically adenosine triphosphate. These cristae are deeply folded to form ATP. Now what do they have? They have got F1 particles or probably we can call them oxysomes as well. And these oxysomes are the site of these ATP synthesis. Now moving on to the function of mitochondria. Mitochondria is almost mostly called the powerhouse of the cell. Right? Now why is it called the powerhouse of the cell? The reason is that it is helping in again ATP synthesis and that is why it is called the powerhouse of the cell. Again, whenever we are discussing about mitochondria, we come across a very general question and that is why is mitochondria called a semi-autonomous cell organelle? So why is it so? What is the reason behind it? Right? The reason is that mitochondria is a cell organelle which has got its own DNA and proteins and this DNA is capable of replicating independently. And that is why the mitochondria is called a semi-autonomous cell organelle. Now this is all about that you need to learn about mitochondria. Now let us move on to our second topic and that is plastids. Now plastids are the cell organelles which are specified only to the plant cell. These are the characteristic features of plant cell only. They are completely absent in an animal cell. Now these plastids were discovered by E. Haeckel. Right? There are three kinds of plastids as you can see here. Chloroplast, chromoplast and leucoplast. Now the first one is chloroplast. As the name suggests, chloro. Chloro is for chlorophyll. These are basically green colored plastids which again will be providing green color to the plants and since they have chlorophyll, they will help in photosynthesis. Now you have all learned from your younger classes that due to the presence of chlorophyll only the green plants are able to perform photosynthesis. So here is the location where chlorophyll is located. Now you need to understand about the structure of chloroplast as well. So let us discuss about it a little. Now the chloroplast has got two membranes, the outer membrane and the inner membrane. Like you have studied in mitochondria has got a mitochondrial matrix. So likewise chloroplast has also got a matrix with itself and that is called the stroma. Right? And other than stroma, it has also got membranous structures like this. And these structures in all are called grana. Right? And these individual disc-like structures are called thylakoids. So these are the structures that are again responsible for the process of photosynthesis. And these are linked together with the structures called stromal lamellae. So what do you know about chloroplast? We know that it has got chlorophyll in it and it helps in synthesis of food in green plants. Now other than that, this stroma of the chloroplast has also got DNA and ribosomes. Since it has got its own DNA and ribosomes, again, chloroplast is also called a semi-autonomous cell organelles. So this is what you need to remember about chloroplast as well, that it is a semi-autonomous cell organelle. Now moving on to the second plastid, which is the chromoplast. Now as the name suggests, chromo. Chromo is for color. So these are colored plastids. They are basically going to provide color to the plants, right? Now these colored pigments can be carotene and or carotenoids and xanthophylls. So how are chromoplasts helping the plants? You all have studied about the processes like pollination, right? Dispersal of seeds, etc. Since the plant will be having color. Now since the plant will be having color, it will help the plant in pollination and it will help in seed dispersal also. Now moving to our third category of plastids, and that is leucoplast. So leucoplasts are again colorless plastids. So what do we know about the three? That these are green colored plastids. These can have any color and these are mostly colorless plastids. Now these are itself, they are divided into three, and they are amyloplast, right? These help in the storage of starch. Again, you need to remember this. And then the second category is aleuronplast. Aleuronplast, they help in the storage of proteins in plants, right? And then the third one is elaioplast. Now elaioplasts are going to help in the storage of lipids in a plant. So now what have we studied about plastids yet? That these were discovered by E. Hecker. There are three kinds of plastids: chloroplast, chromoplast and leucoplast. Chloroplasts are green colored plastids. They will be helping in photosynthesis and they are also called semi-autonomous cell organelle. Why? Because they have got their own DNA and own set of proteins. The next one was chromoplast. They are colored plastids. They can have colored pigments like carotenoids and xanthophylls. They help in pollination, seed dispersal, etc. And the third one was leucoplasts. They are colorless plastids. There are three types: amylo, eleuron and elio, depending upon the substance that they are storing in itself, right? Now moving on to the third cell organelle that we'll be dealing with in today's session, and they are lysosomes. Now lysosomes were discovered by Christian De Duve. Again, a name that you all need to remember, right? Now lysosomes are the cell organelles. They are going to have a single membrane. These have only a single membrane. Now the other two organelles that we had studied in today's session had two membranes, right? That were covering them. But then lysosomes have only got a single membrane. Now lysosomes have got, you know, strong digestive enzymes. They have got digestive enzymes which are synthesized in RER. So they have the digestive enzymes, but they are not synthesized inside lysosomes, but are a production of RER. Now what was RER? RER is rough endoplasmic reticulum. Okay. And these enzymes are concentrated in lysosomes. Now what is the purpose of these enzymes basically? The purpose of these enzymes is that we will be discussing in the functions of lysosomes. So lysosomes are basically called the scavengers of the cell. And if not scavengers, they are also called the waste disposal system of the cell. So why are they called the waste disposal system of the cell or the scavengers of the cell? Because lysosomes have got very strong digestive enzymes that help in cleaning out the cell, that help in eating out the debris. Right? Now the second one that we are going to study about lysosomes is that they are called the suicidal bags of the cell. Now why are they called suicidal bags of the cell? Because once a cell gets damaged, the membrane of the lysosome will burst open and will release these powerful digestive enzymes which will eat up the entire cell. And this process is also called autolysis. And since the lysosomes are helping in carrying out autolysis, they are also called suicidal bags of the cell. Now, this is what you were supposed to study in this session. We have dealt with three topics, that's mitochondria, plastids and lysosomes. I hope you'll be revising these topics and making their notes from your reference book and NCERT as well. Thank you.